Here is a picture of a bridge truss with a pin support at one end and a roller support at the other end. The load on the bridge gets transferred to the pillars of the bridge and subsequently to the ground through these supports. The picture on the right is that of a beam which is fixed to the wall, and this support is called a fixed support. The load on the beam gets transferred to the wall through this type of support. Now, do you know why there are different types of reactions associated with these different kind of supports? For example, you have two components of a force on the pin support, a single force at the roller support, and two forces along with the moment at the fixed support. If you are seeking answers to such questions, then you should watch this video till the end and you will get answers to all of your questions. So let's get started. What is the purpose of the supports? Well, loading on a structure or a rigid body is transferred to ground or other bodies through these supports. It is through the reactions at the support that the ground and other interacting bodies oppose a possible motion of the free body. Hence, these reaction forces are also called sometimes constraining forces. As you know, while doing equilibrium analysis, we draw a free body diagram of a structure or a rigid body, and we show both unknown and known external forces. The unknown external forces are usually these support reactions. Now, there are three types of reactions exerted on a 2D structure. The first kind is a force with known line of action. That is, the direction of the force is known, but the unknown quantity is the magnitude of the force. The second type of reaction is a force with unknown direction and unknown magnitude. So there are two unknown entities. And the third type of reaction associated with certain kind of supports is a combination of a force and a couple. So let's get into detail of the first type of reaction. The first type is a force with known line of action. And in this category fall different kind of supports. They are rollers, rockers, frictionless surfaces, cables, collars, and frictionless pins in slots. So each of these types of supports, they prevent motion in one direction only. And therefore, there is only one unknown, and that is the magnitude of the reaction force. The direction is known. Look at these pictures. These are the rollers in which motion is prevented only in the vertical direction. In the horizontal direction, the support does not restrict any motion. Same is true for a rocker, which can move a little bit in the horizontal direction, but in the vertical direction, the motion is resisted. Same is the case in frictionless surfaces. And therefore, for all these kind of supports, the reaction force will be in vertical direction as shown here. In X direction, there is no reaction force because the motion is not restricted in the horizontal direction. If the member is connected to a cable, then reaction force will be in the direction of the cable, and its direction will be always going away from the body, because cables can only sustain tensions and cables do not sustain any compression, and therefore this force, the reaction force on the body, would always be going away from the body. These are another type of supports. This is a collar. Collar moving on a rod, and the member is connected to the collar. Now this member can move in this direction, but cannot move in this direction, perpendicular to the rod. Same is true with a pin which moves in a slot. So this member can move along the slot in this direction, but its motion is restricted in this direction. Therefore, the reaction force will be always normal to the direction of the slot or the rod in the case of collar. So as you see here, when you draw a BD of the member, the reaction force will be always normal to the direction of the slot or the rod on which the collar slides. The second category of the support reactions is the unknown force, both in terms of direction and magnitude. So supports which cause this type of reaction include frictionless pins, hinges, and rough surfaces. They can prevent translation of the free body in all directions, but cannot prevent rotation. Therefore, there are two unknowns, usually represented by X and Y components of a force. Examples: you have a member of a rigid body which is connected to the ground through a hinge or a pin, and its motion is restricted in horizontal direction as well as vertical direction. So therefore, there will be reactions in these two directions. But this can rotate, and therefore, there is no moment reaction involved in this kind of support. Same is true for the rough surface. And therefore, when you draw the free body diagram of this member, you show a force with unknown magnitude as well as unknown direction. The same thing is usually represented as two components of this force, one in the vertical direction, another in the horizontal direction. So there are two unknowns. So whenever there is a hinge or a pin, you usually show these two reaction forces in X and Y direction. The third category of the support reactions is a force along with a couple. And these kind of reactions are caused by fixed supports, which oppose motion in any direction, whether it's a translation or rotation. So there are three unknowns involved: two components of a force and a moment of a couple. The examples are fixed support. That is, for example, a pole fixed to ground or fixed to a wall, in which case there will be an unknown force of unknown direction and unknown magnitude as well as a couple. And this force is usually shown with its components in X and Y direction along with a counterclockwise moment. So in this kind of a fixed support, you have three unknowns. So the conclusion is, you should not memorize the number of reaction forces that are associated with the type of a support. Instead, you should ask a question: is motion prevented in any direction? If the answer is yes, then add a force if there is a translation motion which is resisted, or add a moment if a rotational motion is resisted. And there is no need to memorize the number of unknowns associated with the type of support. So, having said that, we are now ready to solve the problems of equilibrium of rigid bodies in 2D. So thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.